Thank you for taking the time to join us today as a community to remember those who have fallen during the attacks on September 11, 2001, and to celebrate our local heroes of today. September 11, 2001 is a day we must never forget, when 3,000 innocent victims died on that September morning 19 years ago. It is a day we must never forget the goodness it brought out in millions of Americans across this country. It is our obligation for each of us to remember the day the earth stood still. Remember those who were killed, recognize all who survived, honor the sacrifices of the first responders and recovery workers, and recapture the spirit of unity and service that arose in the immediate aftermath of the attacks. At this time, I'd like to offer a moment of silence as we remember the victims and their families that were altered from the fateful day 19 years ago. May we never forget. Thank you. Now I'd like to introduce Reverend Adam Forno to lead us in an invocation. Stay safe, Pompano Beach, and God bless America.
Good evening, and let us pray. Creator God, we rejoice in this National Day of Service and Remembrance as a celebration of our great strength as a nation to rise up from tragedy to triumph as revealed in the events following September 11, 2001. This power was shown through the lives of those 9/11 heroes who came to the rescue of your people. We are also indebted for the strength as revealed in the lives of those who day by day face danger and service to our country and communities. All active military service members, the men and women of our police forces, fire departments, paramedics, EMTs, and hospital personnel. We thank you, gracious Lord, by whom all courage is sustained, for the contributions which they make fearlessly and faithfully every day. Preserve them, we pray, against peril which always lies in wait, and protect them as they protect us. Shield these heroes from bodily harm. Fill them with single-mindedness that they need to perform their duties, and unite them safely with their families when duty ends. In this time of increasing dangers and difficulties due to our pandemic, intensify within them the special virtues of fortitude, patience, and persevering service, and keep ever before their minds the knowledge that their sense of duty and ready service offered to our communities and our nations is not unforgotten, nor goes unappreciated. Lord of healing, bestow your consoling spirit upon the children, spouses, relatives, and friends left behind of those who've sacrificed their lives in service to your people. Comfort those whose grief has just begun. May our deceased first responders, veterans, and all essential workers find everlasting peace with you, who reign supreme as the one eternal God, now and forever. Amen.
Thank you. On behalf of the Broward Sheriff's Office, Pompano Beach District, we would like to recognize Deputy Sheriff Craig Jacobson for his role in the aftermath of the 9/11 tragedy. When asked to describe his career at the NYPD on that fateful day some 19 years ago, Deputy Jacobson commented, "I always knew I wanted to be a police officer. I come from a family of law enforcement." Craig took the NYPD police exam prior to graduating high school in 1990. He had to wait 3 years to be hired due to his age. Craig was hired in August of 1993 and attended the academy, graduating in March of 1994. Craig recalls, "In fact, my graduation, there was another terror attack on the Brooklyn Bridge." Upon graduating NYPD, Officer Craig Jacobson was assigned to the 77th Precinct in Crown Heights, Brooklyn. Craig stayed in that command until he chose to retire after having 10 years on the NYPD. He was soon hired by the Broward Sheriff's Office and moved to South Florida. On September 11, 2001, Officer Jacobson was assigned to work the afternoon shift. On that morning, Craig described the following: "I was home with my 7-month-old son and received a call from my wife, who told me to put on the news that a plane had hit the World Trade Center. I watched in disbelief as the North Tower was burning, thinking it possibly could have been an accident. I then watched in horror and dismay as a second plane struck the South Tower. Fully knowing I would be called into work, I told my wife to come home right away. As I was watching the news, the channel flashed at the bottom of the screen, and all firefighters and police officers are to report to their commands," was the message. "That would be the last time I would see home for close to a week." Craig pointed out that when he arrived at his command, he was assigned to guard a sensitive post, which consisted of mosques, synagogues, churches, and the likes. He stated, "I was assigned to guard the Union Temple of Brooklyn, located near Grand Army Plaza, for a 16-hour shift. My next shift, he was assigned a traffic post assisting motorists in downtown Brooklyn." Craig mentioned, "During another shift, he accompanied a buddy of his who was in the Naval Reserves to Lower Manhattan. He stated, I had a camera in my shirt and we went to ground zero. I remember looking as far as I could see straight up, and all I saw was twisted metal. With that sight in mind, he could not physically take the camera out and document what he was seeing. It would be another 2 months before he returned to Lower Manhattan, and when he did, he was assigned a security post right at ground zero at the firehouse. I still think about that day," he says, "which is ingrained in my mind forever. I will never forget my fellow police officer colleagues, firefighters, and other first responders who answered the call of duty and who paid and continue to pay the ultimate price." With that in mind, congratulations to Deputy Sheriff Craig Jacobson for your award. On behalf of the Broward Sheriff's Office, Pompano Beach District, we would like to recognize Deputy Sheriff Eric Boyan for his role in the aftermath of the 9/11 tragedy. Eric joined the NYPD in June of 1992. Speaking with Eric, he commented he was hired as part of the Safe Streets, Safe City initiative, which was an effort to boost the department's ranks during a very high crime period in the city's history. Eric commented, "I was first assigned to the 46th Precinct. The 46th is a small precinct in the Bronx covering only 1 square mile. As small as it is one of the busiest precincts in the entire city. I was one of 400 police officers assigned and spent the first 5 years of my career there." In 1997, NYPD Officer Boyan was transferred to the Midtown North Precinct in Times Square, Manhattan. Eric had the opportunity to meet people from all over the world who had come to visit the city at that location. On August 24, 2001, Eric was promoted to sergeant. In Eric's words, "The NYPD sergeant's training lasts approximately 3 weeks. I was training on that fateful morning of September 11th. I can still recall it very clearly to this day. I was training for tasers at the department's outdoor shooting range. As a new sergeant, I was then tasked with supervising academy instructors and recruits who have been mobilized to the World Trade Center after the two planes struck them. This was a terribly sad and trying time. We worked 12 to 15 hour shifts with no time off for two consecutive months. In late 2001, Sergeant Boyan worked the 20th Precinct in the Upper West Side of Manhattan. He also worked the Midtown South Precinct, which covers the southern half of Times Square, and spent several years there as a training sergeant. Eric returned to Road Patrol for his final year before retiring in June of 2012 on his 20th anniversary. Eric Boyan is listed on the 9/11 Health Registry and has regular checks to monitor any potential illnesses. Tragically, so many 9/11 first responders are now succumbing to various ailments from the conditions that they were exposed to. More have passed away from 9/11 related illnesses than were lost on that horrible day. Eric commented, "In 2014, I had the honor of joining the Broward Sheriff's Office and being assigned to the Pompano Beach District. I can say without fear or contradiction that the men and women of BSO are some of the finest law enforcement professionals I have ever worked with. I would like to convey my heartfelt thanks on being honored as a 9/11 responder by the Sheriff's Office and the City of Pompano Beach. We should never forget the sacrifices of all of our nation's first responders who have made and continue to make that sacrifice each and every day. Thank you and congratulations again to Deputy Sheriff Eric Boyan."
Arjun Sergiu, originally from Trinidad, is the first one in his family to attend college. He became a Pompano Beach firefighter paramedic in 2015 and has been a lieutenant for just over 2 years. Yet his medical experience and skill is more akin to a seasoned veteran. The fact that he has also worked as an emergency room nurse may explain some of his outstanding medical performance. Lieutenant Sergiu has responded to multiple critical overdose, respiratory arrest, and cardiac arrest calls with an impressive treatment success rate. Although Lieutenant Sergiu has worked with different crews on different shifts, his leadership and medical proficiency has proved to be unwavering. When asked about his medical successes, he is quick to give credit to his crew members. Not only is he a good leader, he is a team player. Last year, Lieutenant Sergiu responded to three different cardiac arrest calls, each with a different crew. The first patient was a 30-year-old female overdose with an initial EKG showing asystole, which usually has an extremely poor survival rate. Following extensive advanced life support treatment, the patient was successfully resuscitated. The second patient was an 84-year-old female with an extensive cardiac and diabetic history. This patient had an initial EKG of PEA, pulseless electrical activity, that also has a very poor prognosis. Exhaustive advanced life support efforts resulted in another successful resuscitation. The third patient was a 57-year-old male who collapsed at the gym. The patient's initial EKG showed ventricular fibrillation. Lieutenant Sergiu again demonstrated his expertise as he directed his crew through a course of complicated advanced life support treatment. This resuscitative effort also had a positive outcome. This year, Lieutenant Sergiu led two calls that are noteworthy. The first involved a cardiac arrest for a male in his 50s, in which it was known that the man had tested positive for COVID. Lieutenant Sergiu led his crew effectively through this incident, which involved a direct risk to the health and safety of everyone involved in the incident. The second incident involved a 21-year-old male with a stab wound to his right abdomen. Lieutenant Sergiu's decisive action, rapid assessment and treatment, and declaration of a trauma alert were critical factors in ensuring this man's survival. These are just a few examples of Lieutenant Sergiu's many successes. He was provided our 2019 Paramedic of the Year Award, and I believe him noteworthy to be worthy of the local hero recognition as well.
City officials of Pompano Beach for allowing us to present this program again this year. 9/11, a day that will always conjure up memories of the tragic events that bestowed upon our nation that day. But it also gives us time to pause and remember the work and sacrifices being done by our first responders. Today, the pandemic of coronavirus is this generation's 9/11. As in New York City that fateful day, we watched countless numbers of our first responders going forward to confront an unknown situation. Today, our first responders continue to go forward, doing their jobs while facing an invisible enemy. In both situations, many have paid the ultimate sacrifice. Things seem to be so common. In 2001, we cheered, gave thanks, and supported our first responders. Today, the epidemic hit us hard. As we shelter in place, practice our social distancing, we should pause and remember our first responders who confront the invisible enemy every day to protect and serve all of us, even those who chose to protest against them. This 9/11 day is truly different, but the message should always be the same. Respect and thanks. I cannot finish without mentioning our newest army of fighters facing this invisible enemy, some even making the ultimate sacrifice. This army consists of all medical personnel who are tirelessly working long hours just to help strangers in need. Also, the many people that are showing up to work every day, now deemed essential workers, who are trying in a small way to bring some form of normalcy to an ever-changing lifestyle. In conclusion, this 9/11 has a lot of underlying issues. Let us try to imagine the empty chair at the dinner table in so many households, even on holidays, Christmas, everything. That empty chair represents a first responder who could be a father, mother, sister, or brother who is absent from the table doing a job they chose to do and train for, to protect and serve. Families pray every day for their safe return. Just for this moment alone, we should stop, pause, and give a thanks. Yes, it is truly time to put politics and personal judgment aside, demonstrate common sense, and show a little more respect and give thanks to our first responders. Imagine if we can, how it would be without them. I want to thank everyone who took their time to watch this tonight. God bless all of you, and God bless America.
Thank you.